ViparSpectra sent over their P4000 LED grow light to check out, and this one is pretty interesting. It's time to get this light out of its box and test the PAR levels in a 4x4 grow tent. Welcome to the Hippie Geeks, let's dig into this grow light unboxing brought to you by ViparSpectra. As always, the packaging of the light was very secure and it arrived with no damage to the light. This one is pretty easy to unbox, and as it is fully assembled, all that is in here is the light itself along with its hanging hardware. On the back of the light is the heat sink that will keep the LED boards cool, the drivers for the lights, and then on the side is the dimmer dial. Flipping the light over shows you this is pretty much the equivalent of two of their P2000 lights hooked together, which is pretty neat to see. Taking a closer look at the back of the light, and you can really see all of the fins on the heatsink. I love the heatsinks on these lights, as it really does help with the heat dissipation, and also gives a lot of rigidity to the light. You can see that each board has its own Sosin driver to provide power to them, and on our light, the model is SS-200VA-56B. On the side of the light, you can see the adjustment dial, which has a full adjustment range from the minimum light level up to 100%. This light does not have an off switch, so you will need to provide that functionality with a timer. We use smart power strips to control all of our lights these days, and it works pretty well. Looking at the front of the board, and you can see all of the LEDs with the conformal coating that protects them from any moisture in the grow environment. In the middle of the light, you can see where the two different boards meet up, and that all of the LEDs are evenly spread across the board. Now that we have checked it out, it is time to go over the PAR measurements in a 4x4 tent. We are measuring the light levels in this tent because this is the size of tent they advertise this light to be used with, but we will actually be using it in a 2x4 tent, so those measurements will be coming out next week when we go over the tent setup for that grow. At an 18-inch height, the PAR reading in the center is at 1066, which is way higher than I will ever need, as that amount of light will burn most plants. If you are growing something that can make use of those light levels though, it is nice that they are available. This light pulled 403 watts from the wall at full power, and it went down from there as we dimmed the dial. At 75, it pulled 307 watts from the wall. At 50, it was pulling 202 watts. At 25, it went down to 112 watts. And finally, at minimum, it pulled 42 watts from the wall. The light is listed as pulling 400 watts plus or minus 3%, so we are right in line with that. Moving up to a 24-inch height, and the center reading is now at 761 PAR, and as this light gets raised up, the levels are going to be getting more even with the light reflecting from the walls, which is why we grow in tents. We took PAR readings with the light dimmed and averaged what those results were, which will give you the PAR X readings on the left. All of the readings shown on the screen are at full power, and to get the light levels at different dim settings, just multiply the shown PAR value by that number. For an example, the center reading at 24 inches is 761 PAR, but if we have the light set to 50, we would multiply it by 0.52 and get a result of 396, which will get you pretty close with all of the values shown. At a 30-inch height, the center level is down to 606 PAR. As the light raises up, we are able to get more light splash around the edges of the tent, so those levels are staying pretty similar to what they have been when the light was lower. This light is completely capable of growing in a 4x4 tent like this, but as the light is fairly narrow at only 11 inches compared to its 40-inch length, it is going to have trouble keeping the levels even from the center to the edges. What I think this light is going to be perfect for is a 2x4 tent, where its form factor will match up perfectly with the shape of the grow space. Moving up to 36 inches, and the center reading is at 633 PAR, and I will likely have this light hung somewhere between here and 24 inches on the upcoming grow, depending on what stage we are in. After I pulled all of these PAR numbers and the light was as warm as it was going to get, I took temperature measurements of the heat dissipating fins, which were 126 degrees Fahrenheit or 51 degrees Celsius, and the driver was sitting at 139 degrees Fahrenheit or 59 degrees Celsius, and the room it was in was sitting at 74 degrees Fahrenheit or 23 degrees Celsius. Finally, getting to 48 inches, and the center light level is at 435 par with a gradual drop off out to the edges. We are still using the Apogee SQ-420 Smart Quantum Sensor to take all of these measurements, and it is still working out really well. It is just the sensor itself and plugs into a PC to get these readings, so it is quite a bit more affordable than their standalone units. We will leave an Amazon affiliates link to it down below if that is something you are interested in checking out. The ViparSpectra P4000 is an incredibly solid light that can be used in a lot of different spaces. While this light will cover a 4x4 tent, where I think it will really shine is in a grow space that more closely reflects its dimensions. This is going to be great in a 2x4 tent, or it would be a really amazing fit for you folks that are doing a long narrow closet grow where a square shaped light just isn't going to work out very well. A big thank you to ViparSpectra for providing the P4000 LED grow light that we have taken a look at in this video. If you want to check it out for yourself, we will leave links to their lights in the description down below. Be sure to use code ViparGeeks at checkout to get a discount on your order. Another big shout out goes to our channel members here on YouTube and patrons over on Patreon that have pledged at the trimmer level. While all of our members and patrons help keep the channel going, you folks have gone above and beyond, and we really appreciate it.